Welcome to Control Object Access with Profiles and Permission Sets, the third video in the Who Sees What series. These videos provide admins the basics on visibility and data access in Salesforce. Okay, so you've been following along in the video series. You've seen how to grant org access to your users by setting IP ranges and login hours. Now, let's talk about object access. In this video, we'll show you how to create profiles and permission sets and explain how they're used to control object access. Profiles are one way to determine the object's users can access the permissions they have on an object record. Profiles control which tabs are visible and which apps are available in the app launcher. They also determine object access and what permissions people have to each object. Create, read, edit, or delete permissions. As we saw in the organization access video, profiles also contain system settings that control login hours and IP ranges. Salesforce provides standard profiles to get you started. You can't edit standard profiles, but you can clone them and then edit them to create custom profiles. The most basic profile is Minimum Access Salesforce. The Minimum Access Salesforce profile has the fewest privileges in Salesforce. Minimum access users are assigned the Access Activities, Chatter Internal User, Lightning Console User, and View Help Link permissions. This profile's access is expanded by permission sets and permission set groups to ensure users assigned to this profile have exactly the access they require and no more. We'll talk more about extending permissions with the permission set groups in the next video. Next, we have the standard user profile. The standard user has create, read, edit, and delete permissions to most standard Salesforce objects, such as accounts, contacts, and opportunities. There are three additional profiles that are based on the standard user: Solution Manager, Marketing User, and Contract Manager. These profiles build on the standard user profile with additional permissions for areas of the Salesforce app. There's also a special profile, the System Administrator profile. The System Administrator profile has two superpowers: View All Data and Modify All Data. These permissions override all sharing rules and settings, so be careful when granting these permissions to any other profiles besides the System Administrator. Every user is assigned one profile. Typically, a profile provides access for the general functions that a type of user performs. But what if some users need access to additional objects and settings, and you don't want to grant that access to everyone with the profile? That's where permission sets come in. Permission sets take you above and beyond profile settings, so you can grant additional permissions and access only to the users who need them. When working with permission sets, it's a good idea to look at the standard permission sets already in your org and see if they have the access you need. You can then assign those or clone them and modify them to provide the access that you need. As a best practice, build permission sets to correspond to a function or task, like an approval process or updating an opportunity. Let's check out AW Computing's Salesforce org to see how permissions work. Here, we're going to assign a profile, then create custom permission sets for the inside sales reps at AW Computing. Before we get started, let's enable the Enhanced Profile User interface. This interface makes navigation much easier when creating profiles. Let's also verify the latest interfaces enabled for permission set assignments. These settings are located under Setup, User Management Settings. Now, let's assign the Minimum Access Salesforce profile to Mimi Sato, one of AW Computing's sales reps. As we've already done with our other inside sales reps, Diego, Jessica, and Lucia. From the Setup menu, we go to Permission Sets, click New. We enter a label and API name. For the description, it's a good idea to name the permissions and settings that will be enabled in the permission set. The permission set user license must match the user license of the users who will get the permission set. Our users have the Salesforce license, so we select Salesforce. The permission set overview page has two major sections, for app and system settings. App settings specify app-related access settings, like objects, tabs, fields, and app-specific permissions. Let's add some app permissions for our internal sales reps. The reps need access to the sales app. We have two listed here, one for Lightning and one for Classic. Let's add both. Let's go to Object Settings. Here, you can see a summary of object permissions, fields, and tab settings for this permission set. As you can see, we haven't enabled any permissions yet. Our internal sales reps will need to be able to view and create accounts. So let's give them read and create access. They'll need to be able to work with cases, so let's give them the ability to create, edit, and delete cases. They'll need to work with contacts, so let's give them full access to contacts. The sales reps need to be able to create and view leads as well, though they generally don't need to delete them. We want our team to be able to create and edit opportunities, but we don't need them to be able to delete, so let's give them that access. Now we have a general permission set that we can assign to sales reps with the access they need. Next, our inside sales reps do need to be able to delete leads and transfer some leads to other users. We don't want all reps to have these permissions, so let's create another permission set. Great! We've just created permission sets for our inside sales reps, and they're ready to be assigned to everyone on that team. Now you've learned how profiles and permission sets control object access and how to create permission sets. Next, we need to create permission set groups and assign them to our users. To learn more about visibility and access, check out all the videos in this series. Up next, we'll dive into permission set groups. You can also search for these topics in Salesforce Help, or come join us on the trail at trailhead.salesforce.com. Thanks for watching.